struck him, Henry.
Good God, you look terrible. Did someone attack you?
What's life like in Rattai?
Life is good here. Even better if them damn refugees would only vanish.
Do you know if there's anyone around here who could use my help?
Could be.
How are you, Henry?
You're the blacksmith's son from Scullet's, ain't you? The bailiff here could probably use you. He's got some jobs for the Scullet's refugees, but he's not sure who's good for what. He was moaning about it here yesterday.
Be a bit more careful.
I'm glad to see you.
I feel a lucky throw coming my way. How about you?
We'll see.
There, satisfied?
That's it. That's it. Oh, no.
Right here.
Good day, Henry.
Henry!
She made last time to Old Tonda from Tabo, the one I buy goods from. And he said right away he'll take them.
God be with
and
you.
How much
Henry?
Do I want for them?
Well, now.
I was surprised
watch
myself.
It. I remember.
I wasn't sure Betty would even want to sell them.
How are you, Henry?
God save you, Henry!
What's going on there?
Only bandits creep around in the dark without a light.
Where's your torch?
Hey, who's there? Hey!
me sleep. No, let me sleep.
I'd like to know...
What do you think of the Lord here, Sir Hanush?
He comes from the glorious line of the Lords of Lipa. Folks say he's a bit hot-headed, but he took us in, so he must be a good Christian.
Who's this Sir Han's capon?
He's actually the real Lord of Rattay, and Sir Hanush is only his guardian, because Sir Han's is underage and his father is dead. Folks say he's a spoilt young pup with an eye for the lasses.
That's all. I've brought you something.
What are you playing at, Hal? Are you trying to get me drunk enough to have your way with me?
So, how have you been?
I can't stop thinking about Scarlet's.
I know. It was hell. But life has to go on. Why not clear your head and try to forget about it? At least for now.
What do you mean?
Do you feel like a walk?
That's not a bad idea. And where would you care to go?
How about the tavern? They do a fine beer in Rattai.
So that's what you call a walk, then? Sitting down and filling your gullet?
I'd rather take a proper walk.
What if we took a stroll along the river?
Why not? That sounds lovely. Shall we go?
Let's go.
That was a good idea, to go for a walk. Not that I don't like the mill, but you get tired of it, so I'm glad you took me out. I'd love to see the markets in Prague one day. Have you ever been to Prague?
No, I haven't. I have been in Gutenberg, but Prague must be much bigger.
I've heard it's pretty smelly, though.
Yeah, so many people in one place. So many assholes.
That's disgusting. I'd love to listen to that young preacher, Jan Hus. They say he preaches in the common tongue. Everyone's talking about it.
I bet he's just handsome. That's why the women dote on him.
You're a right one. A preacher doesn't need good looks for people to listen to him.
And what about that fine fellow at St. James? I know full well why all the girls have started going to confession, and you have too, so don't give me any of that.
You scoundrel. Well, all right. I admit I find him handsome. But that doesn't make me a bad Christian.
I'd never dare to suggest such a thing.
Tell you what. Let's not dawdle. Last one is the slimy slug. And what about you? I heard you're helping Sir Radzig.
Sir Radzig has me running in a few errands. I have to say, he always treats me well, and I make a wage.
So you've had your turn of luck. What's it like serving nobility?
Oh, it's endless luxury, money, banquets, games stuffed with other games.
A chicken stuffed with a frog.
Yeah, and that's nothing compared to a frog stuffed with a chicken.
A goat stuffed
with a pig. Now then.
Oh, Henry, what am I going to do with you? Wandering the land, turning innocent girls' heads.
The only one here whose head is all messed up is me. How do you always manage to look so good?
Just look at the lady killer. Where did you learn to talk that way?
I don't recall which church service it was exactly.
You scoundrel. But you certainly know how to make a girl feel special.
You may continue. But now I have to go.
Can I go with you?
Just a little way. I don't want anyone to gossip. Thank you for coming with me. Please come and see me again.
Henry, I'm glad you came.
God be with you, Henry.
What is it?
God be with you.
What the hell was that?
How are you, Henry? Good day, Henry.
How are you, Henry?
God be with you, Henry.
Good day, Henry. Henry, I'm glad you came. Good day, Henry.
What is it?
What the hell?
What?
Welcome, Henry.
Henry, I'm glad you came.
Hey.
God be with you.
How are you, Henry?
Welcome, Henry.
Good day to you.
Aren't you Ringler? Milan says I have to beat you before he'll take me on.
And you're that blacksmith's lad, right? What do you want out of it? You're not living in the dirt here like the rest of us.
Maybe not. But why shouldn't I try and beat some coin out of him too?
Yeah, and you can pass it on to us that need it. If you want to fight me, you dandy, then pay up. Or fuck off. Shit.
Give me something to drink, please, or I'll die.
Jesus, look where you're going. Good day, Henry.
Thank you.
Damn.
Thank you a hundredfold. You have a good heart.
Shame!
I've lost everything.
Welcome, Henry.
My home, my family, my life.
Leave it there till it turns black.
God be with you. What can I do for you?
You're Stephen, aren't you? Milan tells me he won't fight me until I beat you.
Oh, yeah? And why would you want to? Well, never mind. I'll fight you if you pay me. What do you say?
Going. I'm glad to see you.
Let's fight.
You gave those two a pretty good hiding, and I made a groschen or two in bets. You Scalitz fellows are good for my purse.
Duh!
I'm glad you stopped by.
I'd like to make use of the bathhouse's services.
So, what are you interested in?
Greetings, Henry.
I'll certainly need a physician to treat my wounds. Then a hot bath and laundering my clothes.
But of course. Money first, though.
I'm not giving you that much.
And how much are you willing to pay?
Is this enough?
More. Good health to you, Henry.
You won't regret spending the money. I guarantee it.
Thank you.
Job, I believe his name is.
Is that so?
You should have seen him. Such fancy clothes. He had a doublet on him embroidered with gold thread. That alone would cost a king's ransom.
I see.
And the horse he was mounted on. I've never seen the like in all my born days. As dignified as a bishop.
You don't have to be an expert on clothes to know it all cost a king's ransom, so to speak.
By Christ. I hope I get a glimpse of him then. It's not every day you get a chance to see such a high and mighty nobleman.
Well, the Scallets lot would have been happier not to see the likes.
Too true.
Welcome, Henry.
May the Lord watch over you.
Welcome, Henry.
Henry, I'm glad you stopped by.
How are you, Henry?
Welcome, Henry.
Greetings, Henry.
How are you, Henry?
Good health to you, Henry.
God save you, Henry.
day, Henry. Save you, Henry.
Here I am.
I'm overjoyed. Have you got a horse?
No, sir. Where would someone like me get a horse?
Good point. Unless it was a cart horse, I suppose. Well, you'll just have to trot along behind me like a good dog.
But, sir, isn't there a horse I could borrow?
Oh, certainly. Why don't you just have mine? Or, then again, you can just run alongside as befits a peasant.
Let's go! Hiya! Hurry up, blacksmith! Look here, blacksmith. About that business at the alehouse.
Yes, sir.
Anush was right. I should have behaved differently. More, well, gentlemanly. But that doesn't mean you were in the right. You can't throw a lord out of the tavern in his own town. Understand?
Yes. I was just...
What? Speak up! Don't worry, I won't bite your head off.
It's just that when you said those things in the arena, sir, I was a little upset.
Ah! I just like to tease greenhorns a little. And you vexed me too. You were insolent to Captain Bernard and they rewarded you with service. Whenever I do anything reckless, even if it's for my honour, Panos is on my back about it and I get punished. Like now.
I didn't mean to threaten anyone.
Well, it's all water under the bridge. Let's not spoil our hunt. Let us talk of something else. Is this your first time hunting?
This kind, yes.
I've been hunting since I could walk. If you're not a complete blockhead, you might learn something useful. And if you don't cock it up entirely today, maybe I'll take you again. It's always helpful to have a minion at hand.
As I said, I have hunted before, but it wasn't...
Chasing bunnies with a pitchfork isn't hunting. Observe and learn.
I'll do the best I can.
I don't know if
that is, sir, I don't know if that's a suitable topic of conversation for the hunt.
We're not hunting yet. I'd like to hear about it at last from someone who was actually there.
The humans attacked Skullets and, he didn't flee.
That's what they all say. I want details.
Is it really necessary, sir?
Arguing with the nobility again, eh? It seems you're a bit of a rebel.
No, not at all, sir. It's just that... Well, it's hard for me to talk about.
I see. So I'll have to get you drunk first.
I'm not sure even that would work.
We'll have to find out, won't we? There's a nice little place just north of here. We'll camp there and you can tell me all about it.
If you wish, sir.
We'll make camp here.
Coming up, sir.
And the bacon? Where's the bacon?
Have it right here, sir.
At long last. So, are you enjoying being on the hunt?
I am, although we haven't actually hunted anything yet.
That doesn't matter. Hunting is a diversion. The main thing is to get out of Ratte for a while. Listening to Hanush's lectures all day long would drive anyone mad.
If I may ask, sir, what does a lord like you do all day?
When I was little, I was awfully bored, I can tell you. There was always some courtier or teacher dogging my footsteps. Now I spend most of my time trying to learn from Sir Hanush. Governing is no joke. At least most of the time. Only last week I had to listen to complaints from my subjects.
But that could be interesting too, couldn't it?
My lord, this yokel here empties his piss pot in my yard.
And sir, that old hag put a spell on my cow. And sir, my old woman is fucking half the village.
Like a flock of sheep bleating all the time. Even study is more interesting.
What are we going to hunt?
Cumans.
What? Cumans? But...
You should see your face! I got you there! We'll see what we can get. But I'd like to bag a boar. One, at least. And a few hares, too, eh? But what about you? Before I couldn't get a word out of you, now your tongue's loosened. So, tell me about Skullets. I heard Sigismund had 100 banners there.
I don't know, sir. I didn't have time to count them. It's not easy for me to talk about, sir. My parents were killed right in front of my eyes.
Couldn't you do anything about it? I mean to say, didn't Radzig put up a defence?
They caught us unprepared. There was no time for anything. I wanted to save my parents, but it was too late.
All right, then.
I was only asking.
I'm not a coward, if that's what you're getting at, sir.
I never said you were.
And I'd never let anyone call me one. Not even a noble.
More honour to you. Well, never mind. Anyway, it's too late to go anywhere today. But tomorrow we set off at first light. Got it?
Yes, sir. Sir, wake up, sir. It's time to go.
What? Are you mad? It's still dark.
I thought we were going to get an early start, sir.
Early means at first light. Light, you dolt. Do you want me to break my neck in the black of night? Go back to sleep.
Sir, wake up, sir. It's time to go.
What? Are you mad? It's still dark.
I thought we were going to get an early start, sir.
Early means at first light. Light, you dolt. Do you want me to break my neck in the black of night? Go back to sleep. Damn it. What are you waiting for? Your lord requires you for the hunt.
Oh, really? Such a renowned hunter needs help?
You wouldn't dare mock your betters now, would you?
Heaven forbid, your lordship.
If that's the way you want it, peasant, we'll meet back here at noon. Whoever has the most hares wins. Oh, and if you don't have anything to shoot with, there's a crate in the camp with some old hunting equipment. You can help yourself.
After all, there's no sport in trouncing some wretch who hasn't a chance in hell.
By all means, Sir Hans.
Ha! You'll soon be laughing on the other side of your grubby face. And now turn your back for a while. I know a few tried and tested spots in these woods, and I don't want you stealing them.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's see how good you are.
How did the hunt go for you, sir? I did quite well.
Look, why do you ask? You were right on my arse the whole time. Not bad, though. Quite good, actually. For a common blacksmith's boy.
Shouldn't there be some reward for the victor?
Jesus, the insolence. A serf asking his lord for coin. But never let it be said I'm a pinch purse. Very well, then.
Your serf humbly thanks you, my lord.
It's getting quite late. I think we've had enough fun for one day.
Hey! Watch it! Lout! Henry, mount up and let's go hunting.
swallow. And it's been freshly rooted. There'll be boar somewhere nearby. So, just like last time, slow and quiet, whatever you do.
Understand?
Or watch out for them from the top of that mound there.
You want to take him down with an arrow?
Certainly. Why wouldn't I?
You won't kill him like that. Boar is hunted with spears.
Is that so? So now all of a sudden you're a master huntsman, are you?
Watch and learn.
Did you see that? Damn, I'm good! Quiet! So, next time you try to tell me I can't kill a boar with an arrow, you can... Fuck! After him! Fetch! Mount up, Henry! We're gonna chase down that swine!
Épp egy malackat tévedt a disznó ülésre. Vigyázz! Látom az ellenséget!
Ott van! Vigyázz! Ezért a megfizet! Légy résen, ott van!
Ja!